In this video, we derive a formula for the relationship between electric and magnetic fields so that a charged particle of a particular speed will be undeflected when it passes through the field combination. This is a really useful result because it allows us to fine-tune the particle speed in a beam of charged particles. In particular, this is crucial for injecting particles into a mass spectrometer, and I'll post a link real quick to my video on how a mass spectrometer works. So in the picture, we've got a charged particle with a charge of plus Q, passing through crossed electric and magnetic fields. The electric field is pointing down, and the magnetic field is pointing into the page, so that's what the X's mean. Since the magnetic force is velocity dependent according to the Lorentz force law, it should be possible to find a special speed at which the electric and magnetic forces balance each other. First, the electric force direction is found by looking at the direction of the field and then realizing we have a positive charge, so the force is going to be the same direction as the field direction. And I'll call that FE. And then the direction of the magnetic force is found by using a right-hand rule. So I'm going to put my fingers in the direction of the velocity and sweep my hand out to the direction of the magnetic field. And the direction my thumb points when I do this is the direction of the magnetic force. So it looks something like this. And I see that my thumb is pointing up. So that's the direction of my magnetic force. So now it makes sense that these two forces can balance each other. They point in opposite directions. And then to work out the relationship between the magnitude of the electric field and the magnetic field, I just say the forces are balanced, so FB is equal to FE. And because my velocity is perpendicular to the magnetic field here, the sine theta in the Lorentz force law just gives me a 1. So the magnitude of the magnetic field is just QVB. The electric force on this particle is given by QE. And it turns out the magnitude of the charge doesn't matter. And this is great news because we can send a mixture of positive charges moving at all different speeds through this device. And I'm going to get a stream of positive charges coming out that are all just moving at this one special speed for which the forces balance. All the other charges are going to crash into the plates. And it turns out the magnitude of that speed is E over B. Let's apply this to a simple example. So in this example, I have a 1 Tesla magnetic field. And I want to compute the electric field that's necessary to select for a speed of 2.2 times 10 to the fifth meters per second. So we're just turning around our speed selector formula a little bit. I can write that E is equal to V times B. That's 2.2 times 10 to the fifth times 1 Tesla. And I end up with an electric field magnitude of 2.2 times 10 to the fifth newtons per coulomb or volts per meter. I then want the required voltage across the plates in order to induce this electric field. So I mentioned the units volts per meter because I can write when the electric field is uniform, which it is between these capacitor plates, E is equal to V over D, so the potential difference divided by the distance that it's spread over. Solving this for V and plugging in the numbers. And I'll go ahead and show the units on this. I can write units of electric field as volts per meter if I like. And then my plate separation would be just shifting the decimal place a couple times, 0.02 meters. And I find a required voltage of 4,400 volts. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.